Today, I want to dive into some cool Minecraft features and share my future plans for my survival series. I know some of you might feel a little stuck or bored in your Minecraft worlds. That's why I want to share some ideas that have kept me engaged and inspired. I've been a Minecraft fan for 8 years, crafting worlds, conquering bosses, building homes, and exploring far and wide. Take my latest world, for instance. I've built a massive treehouse where each room has its own purpose: a main storage room, a workshop with furnaces, a creative room for decor items, a birdcage for my parrots, and a magic room for enchantments. I even have a music disc farm. Next up, a potion room, a lounge for jamming out to tunes, a map room, and various collection rooms. I've never completed a collection fully, except maybe for the colorful wool, that's easy. But with the 1.20 update, I still haven't gathered all the blacksmith templates or pottery shards. Have you? Right now, I've got 9 out of 17 templates and 10 out of 22 pottery shards. My goal? Complete every collection of templates, shards, music discs, and even mob heads. Speaking of which, I've never collected mob heads before. Definitely a challenge. And for music disc 5, I'll need to face the warden in an ancient city. Spooky! I've never done that, except in Skyblock, where escaping on Elytra is easy. But in a dark cave? Where would I even fly? What else should I collect? Should I go for all 900 blocks for a mega museum challenge? Or maybe create a biome museum? I once made a zoo of friendly mobs in Skyblock, and it's adorable. I'm a bit wary of collecting hostile mobs, especially ghasts, though I know some folks have managed it. I'm also aiming to achieve all game achievements. Some are simple, like breeding all animals, but others are quirky, like trading with a villager at the build height limit. Imagine building a house on top of the world and bringing a villager up there. And of course, there's defeating bosses. I've already taken down the Ender Dragon a few series ago. The Wither is next on my list, and I need its Nether Star and Wither Rose. Ugh, I hate Withers, but it must be done for the full block collection. One of my favorite things is tackling more complex projects, like transforming villages. I've already revamped 3 villages. Check out these before and after photos. And I'm even thinking about building custom villages from scratch in jungle and swamp biomes, which aren't naturally generated. Another fun task is designing unique homes that reflect the style of each biome. So far, I've built homes in the taiga, badlands, clay, swamps, and birch forests. I'm planning to create a desert home, a snowy cabin, an underwater base with an aquarium, and more. What other types have I missed? The possibilities are endless, and I encourage all of you to experiment with new building concepts. It's an incredibly challenging idea, but I think it would be a great way to make a mark in the world of Minecraft. Now, I'm moving on to part 2 of the series. Time to add some rooms because, well, I love it. I need lots of rooms. I'm not a fan of cramming everything into one space. Plus, I'm all about building skywalks between rooms. It just adds that magical touch. I'll put the music disc room right inside the house, underneath another room, nestled among greenery. Starting with the potion room, it's going up in a brand new tree. First up, grow the tree next to the warehouse, then bridge over to it. Not a fan of vines hanging all the way down from the tree rooms to the ground, so I'll limit the overgrowth with some cobwebs. I'll arrange the warts around the tree, spiraling up. Thank you. The bottom chest is for potions. Got to keep things organized. I like putting frames on barrels, but now it's a hassle to open them. All right, done here. Now off to gather wood for the next rooms. Time for a quick sprint to my tree park. It's like a shopping trip, but way more scenic. I was playing the game on mute and didn't hear someone shooting at me or that there was lightning. Ooh, got a ghost on the farm? Right. The little zombie's stuck in the corner and can't get out. Oops, friendly fire isn't so friendly in the skeleton world. And on my next stroll through the park, I discovered that the lightning had spawned some skeleton horses. Man, they make some spooky sounds. Now, what do I do with this horse? Keep it? Does it look like a cute pet? Since you're sticking around, I guess I'll name you Boney M. After your bony appearance and musical gallops around the park. Good thing I've hoarded all these signs. Oops, the anvil broke and I totally forgot about it. Might need to schedule more cave trips. It's about time for a descent. While I was running to the park, more mobs got trapped again. They gather there so often. New record! I didn't have the red one yet! Time for the next room! I'm setting up a music listening room. Let's make it snazzy! Right here, going deep. I'll clear the foliage and start building the walls. The wall will feature different types of leaves. Finally, I can move all my music discs to their proper place. They belong in this room. In this room, I can relax and soak in the melodies. Next step! I'll cut through here to go up, making a room for map displays. A flat wall for loads of frames. Hope this is enough space. I'll decorate the exterior walls with leaves and logs, so it doesn't look too flat. I've already made 2 maps around the house. They're the smallest size. I won't make them bigger. But I've run out of iron, can't make more maps. And so this room is also finished. I've wanted to build a staircase here for so long. Next task, make a collection room. I've been looking for a place to set it up, and I've chosen a spot behind the creative room, right here. It will have an entrance here. This corner for smithing templates. And this wall for mob heads. Hope they fit on the shelves. One barrel for colorful templates. Another for templates from ancient ruins. Yes, a new achievement! But it cost me all 4 of my heart-patterned shards. I'll only apply patterns to the sides that will be visible. Obviously, this corner is for ceramics. All done here, too. Before, the parrots just sat in one spot. And finally, they've started flying all around the cage. Next up, the garden. I've been running low on carrots and potatoes for ages. But how should I expand it? Widen the garden or maybe go vertical? I've decided to add a tree here and build a second garden on it. Adding supports to blend the tree with my base. Now, I've got carrots for the villagers, plus potatoes and beets for trading. There's still a lot of space up top here, but I haven't figured out how to use it yet. Now, I'm done. I really enjoyed the building process, and especially the outcome. It's going to be so much nicer and more convenient to play in the future. Thanks to everyone who watched till the end. That's all for now. See you next time.
For 8 years I've been crafting worlds, a Minecraft fan through and through. Conquering bosses, building homes, exploring far and wide, it's what I do. I built a massive treehouse, grand room designed with purpose plan. Storage for all my gear, a workshop filled with furnaces near. A creative space for decor so dear, a birdcage where parrots fly free, and a magic room for enchanting sprees.
Minecraft world, I'll carry on.